نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم، أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا، all you who have believed, اتقوا الله, fear Allah. How should you fear him? حق تقاته, as he should be feared. وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ And do not die, إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ Except while you are Muslim. Death should not come to you. You should not meet death unless, except you are in a state of surrender to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In submission to Allah. Meaning, throughout your life, you should be concerned about strengthening, maintaining your relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not just in the month of Ramadan that we hold on to Allah, that we fast in the day, we pray in the night, we recite Quran, we do dhikr of Allah. No, because death can come in Ramadan and also after Ramadan. So after Ramadan also, what is it that we need to do? Hold on to Allah. Strengthen our relationship with Him. Remain obedient to Him. Submit to Him. Be compliant to Him. Because remember, it does not take long for a person to go astray. Just because a person is doing something good at the present moment does not mean he will forever remain like that. It does not guarantee that his state of faith, his state of iman, will forever remain good and strong. No, iman is something that becomes old, that weakens over time. Just as the clothes on our bodies, do they fade over time? Do they lose their beauty over time? Yes. Then what is necessary? That the clothes be washed, they be pressed, they be maintained, they be mended. Likewise, iman needs to be refreshed also. So this effort of ours of coming together daily and reviewing one juz, this is for what purpose? For reviewing, for refreshing our knowledge of the Qur'an. Why? Why? What's the reason? To refresh, to strengthen our faith. Revive our faith. Because وَمَن يَعْتَصِمْ بِاللَّهِ Then that person is rightly guided. And Allah orders us that do not die unless you are in a state of Islam. So always, every day, every week, every moment, be concerned about your iman. Because death can come at any time without warning. So how can a person allow himself to become distant from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam frequently made dua, Ya muqallib al-qulub, thabbit qalbi ala deenik. That oh, turner of the hearts, the one who turns the heart from one state to another, from one position to another, from one direction to another. And does that not happen? One day we like one thing, and the next day we dislike it. One day, one month, one year, we love to eat a particular food. And the next week, the next month, we don't even want to look at it. If this happens with food, if this happens with our computers, with our phones, we use them. But then what happens? We get bored of them. We want to change. Then what do you think about actions? Does a person not get weary of them sometimes? He does. So what is necessary? That we keep asking Allah for strength. That Ya Allah, place my enjoyment, my joy in what? In worshipping You. That give me comfort through Your worship. That whenever I worship You, then I find comfort. Not that I'm seeking comfort and joy in my trips to the mall, in social gatherings, in coffee parties, in dinner parties. No, these things do bring joy to a person. However, ultimate joy should be in what? In salah. Like the Prophet ﷺ found ultimate joy. Where? In his prayer also. So what do we learn from this ayah? يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اِتَّقُوا اللَّهَ حَقَّ تُقَاتِهِ وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ That no matter how good and pious a person may be, no matter how much he loves Allah and prays beautifully and worships Allah with excellence in one given moment, it is not necessary that he will die in that same condition. Sometimes a minor incident can change the state of a person's heart. It can literally change the state of his heart. Sometimes A person, because of what he's going through his life, he's so emotionally disturbed that he begins to lose his faith in Allah. He begins to think negatively about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He begins to entertain wrong thoughts about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now what happens? Think about it. When there's a storm, when wind blows, then what is it that the wind picks up? What is it that the wind picks up and throws away? It is objects that are light in weight, that are not firmly rooted. A believer, what is he like? His iman is firmly rooted. Why? Because he's constantly taking care of his iman, constantly nourishing his faith by worshipping Allah, by keeping connected with the Book of Allah, by keeping himself in the company of those who remind him to worship Allah, to remain obedient to Allah. So when iman receives this nourishment, it stays strong. Strong like a firmly planted tree. Then what happens? Even when a storm comes, even when there is a violent wind, then yes, what will happen to that plant? What will happen to that tree? It might get damaged slightly. But what will happen after some time? It will regain its strength. It will be standing firm and tall very soon. So our hearts, our faith, it needs constant care and attention. Think about it. When you have a plant, then what is necessary? That you just water it and put some fertile soil in it, fertilizer in it just once? No. Every now and then you have to look after it. You have to water it. You have to clean up the soil. You have to sometimes take the old soil out and put fresh soil. You have to take care of it. Why? Otherwise the plant will not remain strong. It will weaken. This life is very difficult. In this life, there are many threats, many dangers. To our physical body, yes. To our health, certainly. But more to our faith. So just as we are concerned about the safety of our bodies, the safety of our health, we need to be equally and more concerned, in fact, about the safety of our iman, of the health of our faith. So, لَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. So, O Muslims, your end should be good. Life should end with لا إله إلا الله. This is something that we should make dua for. And this is something that we should also strive for. And if we want this, that we want to die with La ilaha illallah, our death comes to us when we're saying La ilaha illallah, then what do we need? We need to stay together. We need to keep ourselves in the company of those who say La ilaha illallah. So that when we are slipping, they remind us. When we are falling, they remind us.